Hello everyone, in this video we will see how to port FreeRTOS on Renesas RH850 microcontroller. This video is not about using FreeRTOS, this video is about porting FreeRTOS to RH850. RH850 microcontroller is used in this video. So we are using F1KMS1 family. So I have ported it on 64 pin. Part number F701690. It is using 8 MHz crystal. This is F1KMS1 family. I will be using CS Plus ID and CCRH compiler. Both of them are free to use. RTOS timer will be the OS timer. It will be used in 1 millisecond tick interval. And tau j one more timer is used, which will not have anything to do with the RTOS. OSTM is the main RTOS timer, 1 millisecond timer. I am using another timer interrupt just to integrate different interrupts in this RTOS. So it's just a proof that other interrupt handlers are working fine. So FreeRTOS version 10.4.1 is used. FreeRTOS is nothing but is a real-time operating system for embedded devices. FreeRTOS is designed for small designs. It's very simple. It contains different tasks for which are scheduled on the basis of priority and round robin scheduling. So which is ticked at 1 millisecond interval. RTOS timer is running at 1 millisecond and you can configure the time period after which your task has to be triggered. So interrupt can also be changed. Kernel is very portable. 3 files are used, but you have to make some porting, few assembly functions out there. Assembly function has to be written, which are the architecture specific. So these routines are nothing but the port which is required for these RTOS to run on any microcontroller. So how tasks are created and schedulers are started in FreeRTOS. So if we can see here, task create function is there. So you have to specify the task, name of the task, priority of the task, and the handler, which handler is used for the task. So this is the only thing which you have to do. Then you have to call the task start scheduler. So this is how the tasks are created in FreeRTOS. Once the tasks are created and we used to start the scheduler, each task will be executed in the time every tick. So the tick is the execution of the RTOS timer. Here it is set at the 10 milliseconds. So we have to define the stack size for each and every task in the macros, which will go as a parameter for the create task function. And the definition of the create task function can be easily seen on the FreeRTOS website. This presentation is about the porting of FreeRTOS to RH850. I will not going to cover how to use FreeRTOS over here. So in this task, 3 tasks I am creating, LED 1, 2, 3. These are the name of the routines which are to be executed each and every tick of the RTOS timer based on their priority. This task only increment a counter over there. So free architecture specific assembly function are needed to port and FreeRTOS to any microcontroller. So these are the function which you have to write the assembly routine if you are going to port FreeRTOS to RH850. So this task has been done. This function is called during each, whenever a task create function is called, port initialize stack function is called, which is to initialize the stack frame for each task. Port start scheduler function start the RTOS hardware timer. Port end scheduler stop the RTOS hardware timer. Previous setup timer is called from the port scheduler function to start the OS timer. Port solve if context is to save the RTOS task context of the current running task. And restore context, this is a macro assembly routine to restore the context of the next task to be executed depending upon the priority. Before start, this is the function call first time before executing the first task. The first this function will execute the first task by loading its context. Vport yield, this is a trap ISR routine. Three autos uses trap instruction to terminate any task in between if it is stuck. Okay, so we have to provide this ISR routine. Similarly, this is the OS timer interrupt used for the autos timer. These all are the assembly routines which has been written to make this porting possible. So path for the autos portable code will be found at this location. So these are the portable .c and the assembly files routines written to make this porting possible. So in GIT hub you will find it at this location. So if you will see in this folder, there will be a folder CS plus and the memory manager folder. In CS plus there will be core port.c and port macro.h. these have been modified as per RH850 microcontroller to make this porting possible. Similarly, memory management, we need heap to create the stack frames in .c. So how the free autos execute trap instruction if it requires to terminate out of some malicious loop. So it is to call trap set function. So in port macro.h file, there we have to define port yield function at trap set. So trap set has been defined in the assembly assembly routine as an trap instruction to be executed, trap 0. So we are using trap 0 interrupt for that purpose. So vport yield is a trap 0 ISR routine which will be executed once that trap instruction is executed. So in the boot.asm file of the CS plus, we have to write that vport yield interrupt at the respective ISR location. Similarly, this is the hardware timer ISR for auto stick. So OSTM0 peripheral RH850 used for the autos timer. So here I have mentioned the routine ISR in the ISR handler address. So main important point which you have to consider while porting is that you have to define port. This has defined PSW value. So this is the PSW value loaded first time when the task has started. So whatever you have done the configuration in your startup file, like if you have enabled floating point unit or you have changed the R base and E base address in the PSW register, that do not have any significance, because during the starting of the any task, first time this default value will be loaded defined in port.c. So you make this default value as per your requirement. So that this will be overwritten whenever PSW initialized while each task is started first time. So this is the most important point you have to take care by this default value of PSW which is loaded before every task is started. You have to keep it as per your requirement. So this is the macro. You define it, what is your requirement as per the PSW setting of RH850. So this function is called first time when the tasks are created. So it is creating the stack frame. It will create the stack frame for that particular task. Three tasks are created, so three times this function will be called and the stack frame is created. So during that time, here that default PSW value of that particular task is saved in the stack frame, and this is the stack frame which is loaded first time when the task is executed. So you have to be very careful with this particular value, otherwise your software will not work as per your expectation. And there is no need to set EI on your own. That will be taken care by vport start function before scheduler task start. So global interrupt enable, that will be taken care by vport start when it will be starting the first task. Before starting the first task, vport start function will take care of this. This is an assembly routine which will take care of this. So GIT hub link for the source code will be found at this location. So free auto documentation, there are a lot of documentation available. You can go through these links for each and every function. Some I have mentioned over here. Most important thing, you have to keep the OS timer to the lowest priority. In RH850 microcontroller, you can set the priority of different interrupts. So OS timer interrupt should be kept at the lowest priority. So this is the first video regarding porting FreeRTOS. Few more videos I will be releasing. Let's see when I get the time. So if you like this video, then please like the video and also subscribe to the channel so that you can get the future notification whenever I make new changes. Thank you for the time being.